many moving pieces. I think that what we're going to have over our shoulder 8 years from now is going to be completely different than what we have in 2012. As the Port Corian saw this past weekend, I mean, the promoters there, they've caught a lot of stick. A lot of things that didn't become public is they were held up a lot because of the North Korean government and what they were doing and the threats, and things came to a standstill for 6 or 8 months. I actually thought, considering the circumstances, getting 91,000 fans in there in the rain on a Sunday with all the negative press that they had, they did a fairly decent job, you know. I think that when you see the overall master plan of their facility, it's going to be pretty impressive in 3 or 4 years. So I think everyone forgets what TMS was like the first 3 years, from infrastructure to the way they ran things to seepage of the track to, I mean, it was one nightmare after another. 13 years later, no one complains about it. They do a great job. It's a great cup event, and everyone's happy. I think that, you know, I'd be naive, and we would all be naive to think that we're not going to have some bumps in the road during the first event. The idea is to try and mitigate as much as we can in the process. But the track layout's pretty close to accurate. Kevin and I and Herman are making a few minor changes that won't change really the layout a little bit. I think it's more just the grading. The radiuses of some of the corners, we're trying to speed it up a tiny bit. That stadium-like section, you know, is really a little bit more for the engineers and a little bit more for the fans so that they can see more action longer. But I think it's a little bit slower than we would have liked, so it's slowing down the overall simulated lap time a little bit too much. So we're tweaking that. Regardless of what anybody tells you, we have not missed a deadline to the FIA. That's complete crap. They don't have a deadline. We are going to be, the next time the Circuit Commission meets in Paris is in February. We're going to have it to them way before then. I mean, we could turn it in even probably in the next 2 weeks. We're not going to, because there's certain things that we're going to do. All the soil tests, you know, we are as familiar as all the residents out here how expansive the clay is out there. It's something we wish wasn't the case, but it's a give or take. You know, you go west, where do you put 900 acres together? How are you close to the airport? How are you close to a toll road? Yes, the land's a little bit more expensive, but how we're doing to fix the land on this side is going to end up being more expensive than land on the west side. You know, just trying to. So it's really more of the right place, the right location, the right view, the right access. This is the right place.
We have a beer garden being built.
Yeah, I was going to say.
I would say that certainly this place is going to benefit a ton. I think the gas station owner down there on the corner has hit the lotto. And I think that all the residents.
Bubba Burgers have made great tracks.
What?
Bubba Burgers have made great
tracks. Oh, yeah. No. Bubba and I have already talked about that. So, really, overall, there's a lot of other things that I'm not sharing with y'all just simply because it's not to the stage where we can. But I would say that everything's really humming along well. We're on schedule. We're hoping to be able to be moving dirt by December, you know, even if it's just starting to do some of the clearing. And I think things are good.